Hello everyone, my name is Gael Level and you're watching my tech channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at those little RGB Wi-Fi controllers. Now if you're like me and you started by buying very cheap LED light strips, when I first moved in this apartment I couldn't afford anything else, and to be honest I wasn't really educated when it comes to all the possibilities with RGB and home automation and stuff. So I really went and bought so many of those cheap LED strips. They would go from anything from 8 euros up to, I don't know, 12 euros was the max that I would pay for them, sometimes with or without the little AC adapters. And they are fairly simple to use, and that's what I loved about them. It was super cheap and I didn't understand why people didn't buy those more often. Turns out there's a bunch of things that are not necessarily wrong, but you know, if it's cheap, it's cheap for a reason. Anyways, now about 7 years later, I have an Amazon Echo. Most of my lights are automated and stuff like that, and I was wondering, do I have to throw away my old RGB strips in order to have, you know, some smart RGB strips if I want to change the color and stuff like that, knowing that the only thing that I had was normal controllers that you can control with like a remote control like that. How do I make it smart? Of course, there are smart plugs and stuff like that that help you turn it on and off using voice control or your phone, but I really wanted an RGB controller. Anyways, I'm gonna stop babbling too much. So I found this thing on Amazon that claims to be an RGB Wi-Fi controller. And as you can see up here, it has the four little prongs that is often found on those cheap RGB strips. Let's do the classic hand thing. There you go. And I think I have a converter or something like that. And basically, this will help us through an app on our phone to control it and also make it compatible with any home automation like Google Assistant or Amazon Echo. So let's try it out. It's my first time opening it. So this is what it looks like. It comes with those little Ziploc bags. I like those. Oh, here you have a little 3M adhesive back if you want to, you know, set it somewhere. That's always nice. And actually there is that little adapter that I was talking about. It's cool. I won't have to go and find one. So that's great. That's really awesome that they provide that. Okay. And then you have the adapter itself. Here is where it will receive the 12 volts, usually 12 volts AC, DC adapter, sorry. Inside here, you will find the setup step. It's what it says. Oh no, it's also inverted. Oh my God. There you go. That makes more sense. All right. So first thing they say is download the free app by scanning the bottom left QR code, free, install the device and switch on the power. Open Wi-Fi setting on smartphone, connect, run Magic Home Pro, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Okay. It's saying that I need to connect to a specific Wi-Fi. I don't like that. I don't like the idea of having to connect it to a specific Wi-Fi. We'll see how that works out. Okay, I have an Android phone here. This is the Samsung Galaxy S20 FE, which is Fenet Edition. It's brand new. We shouldn't have any problems with it. And you can see the QR code they mention at the bottom here. Okay, and the app is Magic Home. Okay, the thing with those controllers and, you know, any of those cheaper smart home compatible products is that they usually require an app. Now I do my best to try to buy stuff that will work with the same app, but sometimes, you know, you don't have a choice and it's like the choice between the money and a different app and stuff like that. You just don't have a choice. So you buy something that will have a different app and that puts you like in a weird position where you have three or four apps to control all of your different home devices. But once they're installed and they're connected, I don't worry about them because I activate them with my home automation system via my Amazon Echo. I shouldn't call it home automation. It's just through Amazon. It's fine. Okay. And then from there, I can just go ahead and scan the QR code. It is also on the product itself, the QR code, but that's always great. So let me put it upright and just scan it. And it tells me to tap and it will bring me to a website. I might already have Magic Pro installed, Magic Home. Let me check real quick. Some way that I try to cheat sometimes is using my previous apps and try to find those devices with my old apps, hoping that it works. It only worked once. I'm gonna go ahead and try to plug it in. So I have my little cable here. This is coming from a 12 volts, and we'll see what happens when I plug it in. I'm guessing there's no LEDs on this. It says 5 to 28 volts, so that's always good. Does it fit? It does fit, at least. I should have done this before plugging it in, so do not copy the way I do it. And make sure you plug everything in before. But it's 12 volts, okay? It won't kill me. But still, safety, number one priority. And you will see a little red thingy. See that red part? Make sure you find it also on this plug. You will see a little arrow at the bottom here. There you go. And you need to align them. There you go. Okay, so I'm getting a certain effect. So that's a good sign, right? That this is a controller and it controls the LEDs. Also, my LEDs are working because we're getting red, green, and blue. I have some of my LEDs where I've tried like a single color and stuff like that. Now, I really, really do not want to sign in on the Magic Home app. Magic Home, let's make an account on Magic Home. Add device. I really, really hope I don't already have an account. User already exists. I already have an account. I am losing my mind. Apparently, I already have an account. Okay, then we have the normal permission requests. Needs to access your location in order to scan for Wi-Fi and blah, blah, blah. I should tap OK. Allow only while using the app. Okay, you don't need to know where I'm at all times. Doesn't make sense. We didn't find your device. Okay. Manual connection. Let's try a rescan first. Oh, there you go. It found something. Happens if I tap on it. Next, we'll take Android Wi-Fi setting from here. Please tap on show. Oh, never mind. Okay, it will take me there. And LED net. Okay, so I'm connected. Well, it's connecting. Couldn't get IP address. Oh, no. Come on. Nope. Connecting again. Connected. Let's try going back to the app. Not this one. Oh, I'm still on the app. Checking the quality of your internet connection. Internet may not be available. Come on now. If you stay connected with this Wi-Fi network, your phone will also stay connected whenever you use this network. Yeah. Keep Wi-Fi connection for now. Just bring me back to the app. Connected without internet. Okay, so it basically connected me out of my Wi-Fi. Try to get back to the app. So I went back to the app and it's showing me a Wi-Fi list. Again, without me being in my phone settings, right? Indeed. So now I can tap. Oh, I need to, I can tap on my actual Wi-Fi and now I need to type my Wi-Fi password. Okay, so I typed in my Wi-Fi password. Let's click confirm. Controller 84. Yeah, I'll probably delete it later on because I need to install it on other stuff like this, this shelf right there. This is where I'm gonna put this. Although I could name it right now. I'm gonna name it Shelf Light. All right, okay. So it's here in my list. I can group it or whatever. And I can tap on it. And as you can see here, it's on green. Okay, it's annoying because like the brightness is too the brightness is too high. Let me try to do something about the brightness so you guys can really see the color change. And the middle is supposed to be white, but I'm getting very, very, very blue lights. Okay, cool thing is that it works. There is a mic setting at the bottom of the app. There is a mic setting, as you can see in the middle here. And it's using my mic to react to my voice. Apparently that's the thing those cheap apps usually do, which is so cool. All right, there's also music, but you would have to play the music from your phone and stuff like that. Functions. 7 color crossfade. I have a list of functions. I only have part of this lighting up, actually. Half of it is not even on. Just realized. Oh, there you go. It's like a bad connection somewhere. Okay. So this is supposed to be a 7 color crossfade, but it's like the slowest crossfade you've ever seen. That's cool. Strobe flash. 7 color strobe flash. And at the bottom here, you actually have a speed ramp. Oh, this is horrible. Okay, this is what they mean by actual strobe flash. Green strobe flash. That's not good. Red blue crossfade. Let's put green blue crossfade. There's so much. There's so much. And then there's custom, where you can create your own stuff. Anyways, I think that's enough. Okay, now how do I connect it to my actual Echo? I'm going to tap on the menu here. And here it says third-party services. And whoop. And here it's going to bring me to the screen. And I'm going to have all the options. There's IFTTT. IFTTT, yeah. there's Google Assistant. And then there's the Alexa. There's she who shall not be named. Okay, let's tap on it. Okay, and then you have to sign in with your Alexa account or your Amazon account. And then you just follow the instructions and apparently that's it. We're gonna test it out. I have the color shift right now. This is not normal. This is just because my connection is weak, but I'm not gonna use those those actual LED strips. So, oh, never mind. It's actually already added since I authorized the app to use my account. It already added it, so I can turn it off. And turn it on. Now I can say, so, turn off shelf life 2. I mispronounced that, okay? I said life instead of lights. But she recognized it, so that works. So, turn on shelf lights 2. There you go. It's a little slow there, but okay. And let's try some colors then. So, set shelf life 2 to blue. That works. I can't say shelf lights for to save my life for some reason, but she understands, so that's what matters. So what's gonna happen now is that I'm gonna be able to control this light. I have another, it's right there. I'm gonna be able to control this one and the other one right behind me, thanks to those things, because I actually bought a second one. All right, so if I manage to find it on the US store, because I live in France, so I bought it from Amazon France. If I manage to buy it, if I manage to find it on the US store or the UK store, there will be links in the description. It may not be the exact same one, but it's gonna go with the same principle. If it's an Amazon link and it's from the US or the UK, it's gonna be an affiliate link. So if you decide to buy them and you buy them using my link, I will get a little bit of commission with no additional cost to you. You know, I made this channel because I really love tech and I'm always buying tech. So there it is. I really want to share my passion with you and hopefully you guys enjoy it. Okay. I still don't have an outro for this channel, but it's been a pleasure and I will see you guys next time. Check out my other videos.